What we do here is go back.
In 2016, Scorebuns was a Minecraft YouTuber. He was pretty much the same as any other Minecraft YouTuber, except he had flair. In 2016, Scorebuns wasn't transgender, he identified as a gay male. His videos were very flamboyant, and he used to shout a lot. His videos, however, aren't the point of concern. The point of concern comes from his posts on a Minecraft server forum known as It's Jerry and Harry. Scorebuns would often talk about his abusive family and his battle with anorexia. Around this time was when I first discovered Scorebuns. As I was making Leafy is Here type content, I decided to make a rant video on this person. He then responded with a video back. We talked for a very short amount of time, and from what I gathered, this person was very mentally ill. I'll be getting into my personal experience with this person at the very end of the video. In his earliest forum posts, he says that his family take advantage of him. They steal money, abuse him, and neglect him. His second earliest forum posts explains that he has an eating problem, that he can't get himself to eat, and that he is anorexic. Scorebuns later took this forum post down in 2017 when Scorebuns decided they were transgender, and in that forum post remained a picture of them as a boy. Scorebuns deleted this image among rumors that he was wearing a wig in his newest selfie. He completely denied the fact that he was wearing a wig, and he said that he just grew his hair out, when it was very obvious he was wearing a wig as his hair was around 12 inches shorter in his previous selfies. Why does any of this matter? Because it proves that Scorebuns is an insecure, lying person. It proves that he was mentally ill from the beginning. It shows you that this person had severe mental health issues, and the only way they could talk to someone about it was to post on a Minecraft forum, which is not only sad, but worrying. In the start of 2017, Scorebuns deleted their Minecraft YouTube channel, which I think is a good segue into 2017 to 2018. In 2017, Scorebuns met a future YouTuber. I will not be naming his name because I know that he doesn't want to be named. Although the person in question now has more than 1 million subscribers, that wasn't the case in 2017. A then 14-year-old YouTuber met Scorebuns. Although the direct details aren't known, there is a now unlisted video interviewing this person about this entire case. Unfortunately, that video has been unlisted, meaning that if I was to link it or play it, I'd be going against somebody's wishes. So I will not be doing that. However, there are screenshots. Screenshots that are 100% real that I will be showing to you today. I'm going to show you some screenshots of how this person has been exposed, the things they've done and said, and how they've tried to hide it. I'll be going over that now. As you can see in the screenshot, this person in question is looking for 16-year-olds as a 19-year-old. Although 16 is legal in the UK, it's still very sketchy and leads to darker waters. In this screenshot, you can see a 14-year-old YouTuber talking to Scorebuns. As you can see, this person says some very sexual things to a 14-year-old. Not only is this now illegal, but I have 50 other screenshots to show, so bear with me. This person claims Scorebuns turned up at their house unwanted. Now, this would be very unbelievable if multiple people didn't accuse him of this. Multiple people, individuals, claimed that Scorebuns turned up at their house. Here you have another person claiming that Scorebuns dated someone when they were 15 and they were 21. How do we know all of this is real? Because every time this person was confronted with this evidence, they would either threaten to leak their docs, fake their suicide, or delete their Twitter account. An innocent person doesn't commit a doc's crime to cover up their non-crime. If this person was innocent, they would not need to threaten, run away, or completely silence people that were accusing them. This person went as far to get their sister on board to confirm his fake death when people brought allegations to him. Now, if you have an inkling of how an innocent person acts or how an innocent person would go about this, you would know that this is guilty behavior. If somebody was to call me a pedophile tomorrow with no evidence, I would go to my lawyer, I would get them either sued or arrested for slander. Or I would make a public statement saying that they were lying. I would not threaten to dox, threaten to silence, or completely fake my death to get away from these allegations. Because if they aren't real, you have nothing to worry about. I personally believe these allegations, because this person doxed me and came to my house 3 times. I even got him arrested and the police took him back to his house in Wolverhampton and he came back another 2 times. This is why I believe all of these allegations are true, because he did the same to me. I want to move on to the final segment. How we can get rid of this person completely.
Let's go get this son of a bitch.
I say we hurt his bottom line. We go to his OnlyFans, we contact support, and we tell them that there is a paedophile on their platform. We go to their Twitter and reply to his fans with this video so they know exactly who they're supporting. It's the only way to put an end to it.